So good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
We are going to have a special executive committee meeting today, and the agenda, as you are already aware of, is regarding the various CSI constitutional obligations. And this meeting has been convened as per the CSI Constitution Article Number 6, and various issues related to our constitutional obligations will be discussed today, and you will have to ratify or won't ratify. So all these points will be discussed. And I request our Honorary General Secretary Interim, Professor Manoranjan Mondal, to start the proceeding. Yes, Dr. Mondal. Dr. Mondal, you unmute yourself.
Myself, Dr. Mondal. Welcome to all to the emergency EC meeting. As our President, Sir Dr. Minal Kanti Das, I explained that this EC meeting has been called in as per the Article Number 6 of CSI Constitution, which reads that President can call a meeting at any EC meeting at any time with 3 days notice for some emergency issue. Here, this issue is that we have some constitutional obligation like holding the election, publishing of the result, institution of the office, next office bearers, and how the elections will be, rest of the elections will be conducted, and what will happen to the next EC meetings, our president's EC meeting and organizing secretary's EC meeting like that, and what will happen regarding our annual general body meeting in future for installation of the office bearer. Those will be discussed in the current meeting called by the president on an emergency basis. I think you have all aware of this agenda by now, and we shall go one by one. The points to be discussed under the constitutional obligation are for completion of the election process of CSI this year. Now the election process has been complete up to the nomination files, withdrawal of nomination, and ballot paper has been prepared, but it has not been yet posted. And how the ballot papers will be sent to the members by speed post or by registered post, because our obligation to send it by registered post. Speed post is also a registered post. We are discussing with our chairman, Sir Dr. P.P. Mohanan, whether we should send by speed post or registered post. He has given consent to post all the ballot to all the members by speed post, whatever be the expenses on behalf of the CSI. And CSI should bear it. In the current situation of the COVID and the current situation of the post office regarding registered post, it is being delayed. We have already posted our newsletter about 15 days back, but it has not reached even in the Calcutta people. I think it has not yet reached the people outside Calcutta. Whether it has been posted about 2 weeks back by registered post. And what happened? We have posted our assent form of Calcutta CSI West Bengal branch, but it has reached.
You don't have to mention that. Mondal, you don't have to mention that regarding the CSI West Bengal. We focus on our central CSI. Actually, okay, just now I have talked to the.
We post our ballot by courier because it is our obligation to send by government post office. It is written in the constitution, so we cannot.
Manoranjan, I'll be interrupting for one moment. Then again, you'll resume. I have just talked to the council, Mr. Sandeep Dasgupta of Fox and Mondal. He has said that speed post is also a registered post because all the formalities of registered post are to be followed. In fact, it is costlier than the registered post. So he has said that there is no problem for sending the post by, the speed post. So that is the point that has been highlighted by the council.
And the Mrinal, the only difference is while the registered post is specific for the addressee, the speed post is for the address. So it is the more, I mean, legally valid is the registered post, but we cannot take the risk because of the undue delay. That is the problem.
I couldn't follow your address and addressee problem.
No. For example, the registered post, it has to be delivered to that particular person. Okay. Post? While the speed post, there is nothing. It goes to that address. Anybody else can accept it. But then, I mean, you, as you said, both are valid. Mm-hmm. But more valid legally is registered. But in this peculiar circumstances, we cannot do the registered post.
Yeah, so now the EC will have to give the consent that we are tweaking with the word speed post with the registered post. So should we go for this registered post or speed post?
May I ask one thing?
Yes.
May I ask one thing?
Yes. No asking. You will have to answer.
No. Which one is quicker to reach?
Speed post.
And you can track speed post. That is another thing. You can track it. Ki kahan par hai, kahan par chali gayi hai. It is online tracking system.
Only problem is while speed post costs 5 rupees, registered post costs 5 rupees, speed post costs something around 40-50 rupees.
That CSI can be here.
Arre sir,
that CSI can be here.
Okay. CSI con 2020 can be here.
Registered post is around rupees 20.
Okay.
Speed post is 35.
Around 40 to 50 rupees.
So regarding the speed post, the EC unanimously decides that the ballots will be sent by speed post. Am I right?
Yes.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Right. Then we are going to the dates and all. Over to Mondal.
Microsoft.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
We have a last withdrawal was 8th July, and the target of dispatch of ballot is 15th of September. It was previously 3rd of September. Now we have decided it will be 15th of September because the ballot has not yet returned from Dr. Mohanan to headquarters being signed. So it will take some time. And we have set the target date of dispatch of ballot is 15th of September 2020, that is a Tuesday. And last date of receipt of ballot will be decided by the EC whether it will be 7th of November or 14th of November. What the EC says? It should be at least 1 month. It should be at least 1 month after dispatch.
Sir, my suggestion is as late as possible.
Okay, so then it should be...
15 November कर सकते हैं without constitutional problem, do it.
Okay, sir.
That will do be okay.
No, my take is we'll try to deliver on 3rd of September as scheduled earlier. Okay. We'll be fastening the process. So that is number one. And we'll be postponing the date as proposed by our scrutinizing committee chairman, Dr. Mohanan, that we'll be putting the last date on either 31st of December, October, or 7th of September, 7th of November.
Yes. I mean, the delay partly is now basically because of the availability of the hologram, as we discussed earlier, because of the further security. Unfortunately, what happened is there is nobody making holograms in Kerala. We have to depend on the Coimbatore. And that territory fell into a COVID zone. So I got it yesterday night. 5 persons are working on that. We'll finalize it today. And we are going to send it on first thing on Monday.
Tomorrow.
That means at least you will receive it by the end of this month, hopefully.
Okay. It will come faster. It will come faster.
Okay.
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 So we'll try our hard.
Our last date of receipt of ballot should be 7th of November or 14th of November. Which the EC decides?
14th of November.
Taken. Okay.
15th of November is Diwali or like that, Mondal? Diwali
15th is Diwali.
We have to do the counting on 15th, Mondal. If it is Diwali, will we have any problems?
It can be even done in Deepavali. It can be done in Diwali.
So it can be done on Diwali.
No, if there are no logistics problem, let us keep it on 14th number.
Why you are keeping on 15th, Dr. Das? Either you advance it or postpone it. Not on Diwali.
Make it seven.
7th is fine.
7th is fine. 7th is
fine. 7th is
fine. Okay, that means the 8th we can do the counting. Dr. B.P. Singh is our outstation security guard. So we don't want to trouble anyone.
Okay.
So the final date scheduled for dispatch is 3rd of September to say another 5 or 6 days. So whatever is the earliest date, we'll send it. And final date of receipt of the ballot is 7th of November, and counting date is 8th of November. Is that final?
Yes, sir. It is
final. Okay.
Done. Okay.
Okay. So fine. Election issue is settled. So election issues are settled.
This resolution or decision is taken. Unanimous basis. Can I take it as unanimous?
Yes.
Okay.
Anyway. One question, Dr. Das.
Yes, please.
How the candidates, how the voters will send it? Speed post allowed?
Yes.
You can send it by
his own expense.
That also make clear.
No, speed they can post. Send it by. Should we request that they can send it by speed post?
Or courier?
We can request them to go do it by speed post.
I think it is their choice. They can send by any post.
Yes.
Okay.
It's a government post.
Tradition is by any post.
Most of the time they come by, speed post or general post. So whatever is the mode of choice, they will decide.
Yes.
Okay.
Is there any harm in requesting
every member, please take this speed post route? Because as we have seen, registered post is going to take 2 months, and our last date will be
speed post.
That last date. So is there any harm in requesting everyone by a mass mail?
No harm, sir.
Will it be prepaid by CSI on the envelope?
Prepaid does not help anyway. Member should bear themselves.
Yeah. Member will have to be.
To make all points clear. Yeah.
So the first agenda is over. Can I go to the next agenda?
Marnal, can I? Marnal?
Yes, sir.
Good morning. I want to clarify that when we are asking them for to send the ballot by general post, we used to put a prepaid stamp of 5 rupees. Now,
exactly.
And we are asking them speed post, then why don't we put the speed post prepaid?
That's what I'm asking, sir.
There are certain difficulties, I tell you, because what we have seen that number of ballots reaching the hot house, it ranges from 1200 to 1400. Now, rest of the money for the is useless. So let it come.
Not only that, the speed post is dependent on the distance. If it is in West Bengal, it may be 50 rupees. If it is Kerala, it is 50 rupees. So you cannot, it becomes difficult.
Okay.
Marinal, that can be done when we are sending the ballot paper. At that time, the address is there. From that same address, it will come back. So that is predefined. What will the cost of speed post? Let me complete. At this time, money is not a problem. Money is not an issue. Issue is just to send and receive it. Now, this is extraordinary. Otherwise, what we are saying, in the rest of the, suppose you are telling 1500 comes and 2500, whatever remaining number is not coming. So that money is also wasted. That may be 5 rupees, or can be multiplied by 30 or 35 rupees. So we have to take this decision whether we can, if we are asking them send with speed post, we have to prepare. rather than asking them to they have to pay.
Actually, prepaid cannot be done for speed post.
Speed post में आप sticker नहीं लगा सकते sir. They don't allow.
उसमें लगाने नहीं सकते हैं.
आपको पैसा ही देना पड़ेगा. आपको पैसा
देना पड़ेगा.
We are not asking. We are only giving them an advisory that they can do it.
The members should pay. Members should pay.
Send a mass mail, Mrinal.
Okay. If they prefer, the they will send it. Yeah. So
you can definitely add an advisory.
Okay, we can send an advisory.
Yeah. Next.
Acha. Okay. Now, Manoranjan, second agenda.
Yes, sir. Our second agenda of the meeting is organizing the annual conference CSI 2020 as per article number 7, page number 18, modes of conference. What should be the modes of conference in this COVID time? Should it be virtual or should it be hybrid or should it be physical, which is very difficult to hold in this situation? Let us discuss.
Yes, Dr. Mohanan, please.
And here I will need all our erudite members' wisdom to help me, because these are all unprecedented times. And I honestly also wish Dr. Dev to be around. If he's around, and he can also advise me what to do, because this has never happened earlier, unfortunately. We were planning, if you look at our website, we have a website from this month, CSIESC2020.org. We have prepared the entire 4.5 days program last month itself and put it in the website. But we know that it is impossible to do a physical meeting at Ahmedabad in December. If you remember, last time in our meeting, we thought we will possibly postpone it to February. But then we know, because of the logistic reasons and the fact that we may have to have an installation of the obvious barriers a little earlier, we thought that we have to do it in December itself. So the dates are going to be in December, and it will be a hybrid meeting, meaning that the most of the academic sessions will be virtual. And of course, all of us are going to be there, God willing, that at Ahmedabad, and we can limit the physical meet to maybe 2 days or 2.5 days. That is what I am going to look at it. So I am planning something like a CSI week starting from 6th December to 13th December. But our presence will be there at Ahmedabad on Friday, Saturday, and we come back on Sunday. So, earlier, again, as you remember, 4.5 days, we had about 98 to 100 hours of CME hours. Now, because of this limitation, I am dragged down to something like 30 hours or 35 hours. But what we do is, on 6th Sunday, we'll do a pitch talk, maybe from, it can be such a Sunday, it's an extensive program. From Monday to Thursday, it'll be only limited hours, something like what the ACC has done earlier, the AHA is planning, or every meeting is now digital, except maybe the ESC, who is done from morning till evening, which we know that the difficulties of it. So from Monday to Thursday, it'll be few hours, from 4 o'clock to 9 o'clock, or 4 o'clock to 8 o'clock, or 5 o'clock, whichever we decide. From Friday, Saturday. Friday, we can have the inaugural session. And I will request, if Dr. Keval is agreeable, we can even combine an inaugural plus a convocation program. And on Saturday, we have our AGM. And Sunday is definitely a free day. We have our EC meeting, and then we can end the program anytime we want, since it is the academic program is going to be digital. So this is in this way, possibly we can get about 35 to 40 hours, and we can include most of the, of course, we will have our regular plenary session, the presidential addresses, even the CSI data the NIC data presentation, as we discussed earlier, on the key days. The ACC combined session, ESC sessions, This is what our scientific committee, which has been toiling for the last 6 months, intend to do. And I need your valuable ideas, I suggestion. Thank you.
Yeah. Now you are to opine. I'll put my opinion as per the constitution later on. But you just opine what you want to have actually regarding the conference. But it will be very good if you open up the page 18 of our constitution, then you'll be able to give your opinion much more in a definite way. Hello?
You can read it.
Okay. As per the constitution, page number 18. So point 3, organization of the conference. We should have 3.5 days of conference. The first day will be CME and rest of the days, blah, blah, blah. So this is the requirement of the constitution. Since we are having a very bad time, so that's why I think it is my suggestion that we should follow the constitutional norms, at least for the time being, till we are not clear about our going overboard to the constitution. So that is my suggestion and my opinion. Based on the constitutional requirement.
No, the requirement says about the minimum time. It doesn't say how you can expand it. No harm in expanding. No harm in expanding.
Just whenever you are committing that you are organizing the conference for 7 days, it means you are violating the norms. And number two, you are accepting that it's a real virtual conference, which we don't like to mean, because we should give the option. If they want to give the lecture on platform, they should give. If they can't, then they will go for the virtual. That's why it has been called as virtual
thing. So the constitution demands the duration of the conference would be 4 days.
Yeah,
constitutional demand is conference would be 4 days. First day CME and WhatsApp, etc., and the others as usual.
May I give my opinion?
Yes, Soumitra, please.
Yeah, if somebody goes by flight to Ahmedabad, stays there for a couple of days, goes to hotel, goes to the conference center and comes back again in flight, it does not matter whether he stays 2 days or 4 days. So once it is there, once the delegates are going there, we have to go there physically for the GB, for the general body meeting, for the EC meeting and for the conference. It really does not make a difference whether it is 2 days or 4 days. And most people don't stay for 4 days. They go there for 1 or 2 days and come back. So why don't you keep it as such? Maybe there will be a thinner platform. What we could do, my suggestion is that a live telecast, maybe in the Facebook or media, of whatever is happening on stage, so that who cannot attend can see it from their home. But it should go on as with a live telecast.
Mrinal and Soumitra, I have spoken to quite a number of faculties. No one is prepared to travel to Ahmedabad. You want a physical person with a 10 people, 15 people, we can do it. But my suggestion will be keep the academic program digitally, as everyone is doing. Every platform is doing that. And rather than making a sham of the academic program by having 25 people, 30 people, we are compelled to go there. 30 people, and then...
Dr. Mohanlal, I am not against digital. What I am saying, then the whole thing should be digital, including the committee meeting and the GB.
Why this sham partial meeting? What is the purpose? What is the compulsion for
there? The whole thing should be digital then.
You are anyway changing the constitution by having a virtual scientific program, any which case. So it does not matter. That's what executive committee is for, right? So we should do an entirely virtual. Why this sham about going to Ahmedabad? What is the compulsion?
Praful for AGM and EC meeting. That's all. For the academic
EC meeting and EGM also have it virtual only.
The problem of 2 days or 4 days, there is a question, because we do not know what will be the rule of the day at that particular time.
We don't know.
Quarantine rules. Yeah. So if it is 2 day no quarantine, people will come. If it is 4 day quarantine, people will not come.
We don't know. We assume that we are not going to be normal then. Absolutely. So we have to do 100% virtual. Absolutely. And absolutely, towards that, you change the constitution as an executive committee and do the AGM also virtual. What is this sham AGM? 10 people who are going to go there, they're going to have an AGM amongst themselves. Then how have you kept up with the constitution? I do not understand what is the compulsion for a hybrid meeting at all. I really 100%
virtual. The government of India, the government of India corporate ministry has given an order some last month saying that a virtual AGM is okay, acceptable.
Exactly.
The government, there is a circular. I can show it if you want. There is a circular.
Reliance has had a virtual meeting of its all shareholders, some 3 lakh plus shareholders, when they launched the Jio platform. Everybody can change their constitution. What's the problem?
Is there any other opinion? Any other opinion apart from this?
Yeah, I personally feel that we are not in normal times as far as the CSI is also concerned. So we should take a legal opinion. And there is a case in the court, we should not take it lightly. If there is a provision that we can legally make it a virtual is the first choice. But if virtual is not possible, then at least the GBM and the EC meeting, we will have to do it in person. And the academic part can go virtual. Academic part has to be virtual. There is no second opinion about that. So but if legally we feel that we have a very strong opinion, because see, if everything was fine with the CSI, then it was a different. Now there are some matters which are sub judice. So we have to consider that fact in mind.
Okay, any
Dr.
other
Das.
Opinion?
Yes, Dr. Das. Yes. Can we postpone you up to January or February? What is my
No, that has been discussed at point number one, man. That has been discussed at point number one. We cannot. There are obligations from constitutional point of view. We cannot postpone because you'll have to have the budget passed, you'll have to have the audited account passed, annual report passed. So many things are there. Conference can go to the docs. There is no problem for the conference part. But all the other requirements are very, very important. Now, any other opinion? Any other opinion?
Manal?
Yes, Dr. Goswami.
Yeah, we have a precedence when there is a natural calamity in Chennai. We postponed that time meeting and nothing was happened. So this is time again there is a natural calamity.
Yes, Dr. Goswami.
I don't know whether it is unconstitutional if you are postponing to January or February, because we did it when it was in Chennai.
It was in Chennai.
We have a precedence for that.
Yes.
Because so
I'll come to that.
What is the wrong or right? Definitely, all the points are being taken. Any other viewpoint? Any other viewpoint? There are 24 members.
Rakesh. Sir, we have something to say.
Sir, definitely, America, I should listen to everybody.
No, you Rakesh, tell.
Sir, in my view, what I presume that hybrid word which has been proposed is at present not a wrong word. I don't think in December you will, from first they are going to unlock 4, they are going to open every hotel, everything. From 15th of September, they are going to open everything. So if it is possible, if the conference is in December, so the hybrid one is not a bad option. I think it's a good option. You can have all your legality there and you still have a conference there. So if you can, it may be possible that if I am there, you ask my lecture in Hall A, I can give in Hall A. What is the harm? So you can have still a hybrid lecture also. Dr. M.K. Das, you will give 2 lectures to Dr. M.K. Das. He can take in Hall A and it can be virtually transmitted. And the Hall A will run all the virtual halls. So there may be presence of some persons, there may be a, and we can do all the legal things like EC meeting, convocation, inauguration, and AGM. And I don't think doing AGM virtually is a good idea. I am at present, it is not constitutional and it is also not feasible. You will have so many things in that AGM, you are not able to manage. This is my personal view.
Okay, any other opinion? Dr. Gupta. Dr. Rakesh Gupta.
Hello. Yeah, yeah. Good evening. Good afternoon, everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, the scenario is such at present, many cities are there getting stabilized over a period of time. I can talk of Delhi. I'm sure Dr. Praful can also talk of Mumbai. Many cities are getting stabilized for a period of time. And both the things like virtual and hybrid, they are possible. And if the condition becomes conducive over a period of time, we should think of both hybrid as well as virtual. And we should keep our door open for both the things together, rather than just thinking of only virtual or only hybrid. Let the time mature and we should think of these two things together. And I little bit agree with Dr. Yadav and Dr. Mohanan ki look, we should have some kind of a activity maybe for a day or so. And for only those people who want to travel to that particular place or city. It's not a compulsion for anybody. I absolutely agree with Dr. Praful Kelkar. Look, many people are doing a virtual conference also. And if the condition do not improve, automatically we'll have a virtual conference. So we keep our door open. Let's keep it for a day or whatever it is, 6 hours, 8 days or Saturday, maybe morning till evening, a hybrid kind of a conference on the last day and rest as a virtual. That's what my suggestion is.
Okay. Any other opinion? Any other? Dr. Harshvardhan?
Yes.
Dr. Harshvardhan?
Yeah. You see, I think definitely we are going through very uncertain circumstances and we can't predict what is going to happen in day one. Obviously, as the things are stand today, the total physical meeting may be almost impossible. Second thing is to do an hybrid meeting. And in the hybrid meeting, that can be an option, but still we can be flexible with that. And we can assess the situation. I think at the moment, the best strategy will be to plan a hybrid meeting. And at the end, if we find that the circumstances are not conducive, we can convert into totally virtual meeting. I think that's what we should
do. Thank you. Any other opinion other than all these that have been communicated so far? Any other opinion?
I think the hybrid is a good model. And in fact, in case the situation improves, we can have more hours in hybrid, like more of physical. Instead of just 6 hours, we can make it half a day, 1 day, or 1.5 days. Because most of the meetings internationally also are now moving towards a hybrid model where they have the speakers in the place and the audience is all over outside. So it actually gives better transmission and it is a better meeting. So we should start with the hybrid, and if the conditions improve, we can actually increase the number of hours which are of physical meeting there. But only virtual may be not a good idea because, again, the GBM is very difficult to do a GBM and voting, and everybody speaking on even on the biggest platforms, depending on the internet connectivity, there could be a lot of issues there.
Okay. That's it. Yeah, any other opinion? Any other member wants to speak out their mind? If not, then I'll sum up the whole comments from different esteemed members. Actually, before the whole process started, I should have explained what is hybrid. And first thing is hybrid is a new term, which is actually the combination of the in-person plus virtual. Now, literally, everything will be virtual, even if it is in person, because everything will be telecast by Facebook and YouTube and all. So whether you are there or not, your lecture will be transmitted across the globe, not only in our country, across the globe. It will go via Facebook as well as any other modalities like YouTube and all. So this is the pattern of hybrid conference. Now, we already saw many platforms where almost you'll see as if the platform is like the real one, but it is actually virtual. So your picture will be shown in the top, and the virtual platform will be there, and you will be delivering lecture, whether you are giving it from Kerala or from Kolkata or from Delhi or from Chennai, anywhere you can give the lecture. And if you want to give the lecture directly from Ahmedabad, then also it will be shown everywhere across the globe. So that is the meaning of the hybrid. Now, so far I have heard from majority of the members, they are for hybrid. And in fact, hybrid is a possibility, and this will be a unique one for the first time by CSI. So that is there. Now, the benefit of hybrid is that we cannot call it really virtual. If the people are there who want to come over to Ahmedabad, the arrangement will be kept there, subject to their application and registration and everything. And even I tell you, Central Parliament, the Parliament is also organizing the in-person conference, but not in the main hall. They have kept provisions for the sitting arrangement just on the corridors and the chambers and all these places. Same model will be followed even in our conference. So the arrangements for the the delegates, whoever will be there, maybe 100, maybe 150, not 50, not 10. If it is a 15, I'll feel ashamed of our CSI is doing not fine, because we have got 32 members, executive committee members. So how can it be 15 or 16? It should be at least 30, or if not 30, at least 25 plus. So apart from that, there will be organizing committee members. So they should be also present there. So the number should cross, in any way, it should cross 70 to 100. So that is the number we are expecting. But if someone wants, then definitely we'll be going for the accommodation as well as the lectures from the different halls. But all will be virtual. All lectures will be presented virtually. In fact, I don't know why Dr. Praful Kerkar has said like this. His whole meeting was actually virtually transmitted across the globe. My friend from California was telling that he is now watching the conference. Exactly. So it is basically the same thing, same model will be followed even in this conference. We have talked to different vendors. They have said that there will not be any further comment, because we'll have to finish the meetings. So it will be a hybrid conference. That is my proposition. It will be a hybrid conference, and in person, whoever is there, whoever will be present there, they will be going there, and whoever is not present, they will be delivering lecture from any corner of the country or even from outside, because the people from outside, they will not be coming, almost sure. So they will be giving their lectures from outside. So that is the arrangement that should be done. So now, after listening to this, should we take it, or we should be going for totally virtual and whatever have been, don't repeat. I mean, I request all of you not to repeat, whether you go for it or not. That is the primary concern.
The academic program is virtual, and the control obligation is physical. It is simple for me.
Yeah, that has been already explained by the whole hybrid concept.
As Dr. Wander suggested, what is the legal opinion on this? Do we have any lawyer telling us that constitutional obligation means that it should be in part partial?
No.
This is. I have not yet understood the advantage of a hybrid. And if you think that some out of 33 executive, I think it would be irresponsible on my part in terms of COVID epidemiology to try and make it in person when a virtual platform is available. It's your obligation not to have meeting in terms of COVID prevention. This is a sham that we are creating.
No, I don't like the word sham. I won't like the word sham because
yes, sham partial is a sham according to me. Some constitutional obligation where nobody even knows legally it is an obligation or otherwise.
No. What is the meaning of the constitution? Then we'll have to define.
Yes.
We'll
have to know. Constitution meeting does not anyway allow you to have virtual platform for the meeting or the days.
No, that is not the thing.
But the constitution does not allow you.
I think let us be quiet. Let us take the decision. Whoever wants to be there, Nanal at Ahmedabad, depending upon the circumstances at that time, we can then. We have at least the President CC meeting coming up. So our presence can be something which let us plan the academic program virtually. Absolutely. And then the presence of it, and other thing, let us presume that we will be able to go and attend. But right, if the situation is not conducive, we will change. What is the problem? So we have at least 3 months to go.
So the final conclusion is, it will be hybrid, and if the condition improves, we can go for more hybrid pattern and more in-person pattern. If it does not, then automatically the lectures and everything will be virtual. In fact, everything will be virtual, whether it is a in-person conference in the month of, say, next October or next September, or even in December. Everything will be virtual, not related to the presence of a person. Irrespective of the presence of the person, it will be virtual. But whether he'll come or not, that will be dependent on the particular person. And that is the thing we are now subscribing, that the lectures will be virtual. Whoever is present in Ahmedabad, he can go for the on-platform lectures and presentations. Is that all right? Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. Thanks, everyone. This was a very, very tedious issue, but definitely I'll explain to Dr. Kerkar about the constitutional obligation at the end, after we finish up certain
agenda. But then, Mrinal, one small point is, as Praful said, we have to get the legal validity, because somebody may say you are putting the GBM and I am not able to travel because of this and that. So let us, if whether there is any possibility of having again a hybrid AGM. So get the legal correctness. That is very, very important.
Absolutely.
Yes. Actually, we took the legal opinion, yes, not in writing, but verbally. We have already taken the legal opinion. They said that there is no problem for the hybrid sort of meeting or in-person sort of meeting. If the advisories are followed, or if there are no stopover over the meeting, or if the government says otherwise, there is no problem in holding the meeting. So that has been taken from the legal people. And as the point has been taken already regarding the sending the the ballot papers by speed post also. So both the opinions were taken from the
also legal the people. Annual report sending. Now, annual report we have to send to everybody.
We are coming to
we
that.
Can, we can possibly it. Mail it, Mrinal.
Yeah, we are coming to that. We are coming to that. Now, third agenda, Dr. Mondal, third agenda.
Sir. Our third agenda is fellowship convocation ceremony, right, as per article number 15, page number 26. Fellowship convocation ceremony.
Yeah, so this fellowship program could have been in person, but as Dr. Goswami has already opined in the last core committee meeting, that he wants or he likes it to be virtual. So we can do both. It can be also hybrid. If someone wants to have the thing on the podium, then we can arrange for it. But Dr. Goswami, if he likes to come over to Ahmedabad, definitely we'll arrange for that thing also. If he's not there, he can be present in the convocation ceremony virtually also. In fact, the chief man who will be the chief guest of the convocation ceremony, he will be delivering the lecture virtually. So basically, it will be virtual, though I am calling it or putting it in the same bracket as hybrid. So is that all right, Dr. Goswami?
Hello, it's okay.
It's okay, fine. So we'll go ahead with it, hybrid plus minus virtual, or rather virtual plus minus hybrid. Yes. Next, let's go to the next agenda. Yes, Dr. Mondal.
Yes, sir. Our next agenda is 4 EC meetings are required to be completed statutorily. We have completed our 2 meetings. One is the incoming meeting and the headquarter meeting, and also a 1 EC meeting over virtually in the month of June, probably. So, 3 meeting completed. Another 3 meeting I think to be done, and 1 EC meeting or incoming meeting to be done in December. These 4 meetings to be completed by December. One is the president's place meeting, another is the organization and secretary's meeting of CSI 2020, and one is the incoming EC meeting, outgoing EC meeting. 3 meeting of this EC and 1 meeting of the next EC.
So before you comment, I just propose something from my side, since one of the meeting is President's Place meeting. So I personally want that it should be in person. We have talked to the hotel people. They will arrange for all the formalities for keeping the distance, keeping the sanitizer, keeping everything. And the EC members will be coming the afternoon before. And that day there will be a seminar, say half an hour seminar or 1 hour seminar. And after that, the next day for 1 hour, there will be President's Place meeting. So this is the proposition by me. And since the another meeting is also due just after that, that is the venue meeting. So these can be put together as it has been arranged in Delhi last year, the President's Place meeting, as well as the venue meeting were put together. So we'll put 2 meetings, one after another, on the same day, that is on the President's Place meeting day, so, and followed by the venue meeting. So we can complete at least 2 meetings simultaneously. So that is my proposition, and you are to opine on this and also give your suggestion.
I think Dr. Meena traveled to Kolkata last week. So traveling to Calcutta, I suppose, is not an issue these days. Am I right, Dr. Meena?
Yes, sir. I have gone for a DM examination.
Yeah.
Inspection, MCA inspection.
Okay. So that means so maybe once you proclaim your diet, Mrinal, yes, at least we can be there, and we can, as you said, we did it in last time at Delhi, the president's meeting and the organization can be combined, and we can finish up these 2 meetings.
Okay. May I say one thing?
Yes, please.
The venue meeting ideally should be in the venue. So why can't we club it with the outgoing meeting in month of December?
That is possibility. But since it is again a statutory requirement that we should inspect, so Dr. Dani will give all presentations by PowerPoint or video format. So we'll be virtually there again.
Sir, venue meeting cannot be an outgoing meeting because venue meeting has to be much before. The purpose of
venue Samitra, the venue meeting is supposed to be in July. Yeah, you can't do it in the outgoing meeting.
It has to be in the venue.
Right. It will be unfair to do it.
Yeah, we'll be in the venue virtually.
Virtual venue.
With president's meeting, it can be clubbed.
So we can organize the in-person meeting because if you give me the actually go ahead, then I'll arrange, I'll book the hotel and everything within 2 days or so.
And Dr. Dash,
yes,
we all need to stay in hotel. It hasn't been for 1 year we haven't been in hotel. All local people comes, also, please.
Yes, it will be arranged for everyone, whoever wants. We want the number. Okay.
Thank you.
Dr. Sumitra Ray has not come out of the home for a long time.
Yeah.
Independence Days.
Okay, so let us go to the
Probable date, Mrinal, in your mind? Probable date. Probable. It need not be specific.
Since our last date has been postponed to October or first week of November for the ballot thing, counting and all. So it can be arranged in the month of October before Puja or after Puja.
Okay.
But not in the month of September.
No problem.
I'll have to take some time.
Preferably before Puja.
Before Puja, yeah. So, okay, fine. Let us go to the fifth agenda, annual general meeting. Dr. Mondal. Dr. Mondal, please.
Unmute yourself, unmute.
Yes, Dr. sir. Before going to the next agenda, I want to hear from Dr. Dani whether he agrees for the organization secretary meeting at Calcutta or not.
No. Dani is, as you know, that Dani has not been invited. This is a special executive committee meeting. We cannot call any other person other than the executive committee.
No, the president, you can talk to Dani and then...
We'll talk to Dani and we'll because I already talked to him. We told that whatever decision we take, we'll be informing him by today itself.
Okay, sir. Okay. The next agenda is our... What will happen to our outgoing meeting and our incoming meeting? What will happen to our outgoing meeting and incoming meeting?
Since we are planning a hybrid, we will do it on Friday and Sunday as usual.
Okay.
Namranal?
Yes, yes. Since it will be hybrid, so we can organize it there itself. But again, if some members want that they should not be there, like Dr. Kerkar, he is apprehensive. So we'll keep arrangement for the virtual meeting also. We'll be keeping the Zoom also on.
Yes, sir. Okay, then we proceed to the next agenda. That is the agenda number 5, annual general meeting. Annual general meeting, as per article number 5, page number 13 and 14 of our constitution, and this is the most vital program which cannot be done virtually. AGM, can it be done virtually? What is the opinion of the House?
I think we discussed it and we have already discussed. Why raise it again? We have already discussed it will be there in Ahmedabad and we already finished that.
Okay. Yeah, so it cannot be actually virtually, as evident from the central governments as well as election commissions. You know the approach. Even in Bihar, they are organizing the election process in person. Then in parliament, they are organizing the sessions in person, but in a different mode, not as usually. So it will have to be again in person, and there is no question of hybrid annual general meeting. It will be in person meeting. Usually the statistics says that 60 to 70% are present there in most of the time. In some occasions it was in the range of say 100 to 125 or 150, and only on one occasion almost 11 years back in Delhi, there were around 350 plus members. So that was the only occasion where the decision regarding the election process was taken, whether it should be virtual or modality. So that decision was taken there. Only that time it was 350 plus. Otherwise, the range is from 100 to 150. So that is the number. Now, if it crosses also, we can arrange for their sitting there in the hotel itself, in different halls, different rooms, and as is being done in the parliament.
Mrinal, just one point. The Google doctor says a hybrid AGM is valid. So just get the legality of it, because we don't want another case coming up against us saying that you are doing a GBO with 30, 40 people and we are at a loss. Get the legal opinion for that also, please.
Can I say something?
You see, already we have taken the opinion. They said that you can go ahead with the in-person. There is no problem. But regarding the hybrid, hybrid means in person plus the virtual combined together, we have not talked, because that is not feasible. You cannot accommodate in a thing where everyone will have to be shown, their face will have to be shown, and their opinion will have to be heard. If 4,500 members log on to the system, it will be a total failure. So it is not feasible even by any standard.
Feasible to have, 10,000 people was there for the Reliance. So feasibility ka baat nahi karna. Feasible to have, but legally check karo. Legality check karo, please. Legality.
We'll take the written thing about there. Okay. But mind it, what you are talking about, Dr. Kerkar also said earlier, Reliance, ITC, and all these are corporate houses, not societies. Mind it, society is a different ball game, and you know, the corporates are different things or different animals together. They have their majority, especially in India, majority is by the promoters themselves, not by the general public, not even in case of the governmental public system, PSUs also, it is the government is the main shareholder, and we are not shareholders here. It is a society.
Okay. The point is well taken. I understand that you cannot have a virtual annual general model meeting, and it will be very difficult to control it, as what you are saying, it isn't it?
Right, right.
But the legal opinion should be taken.
Yeah, but we'll be having a written
what Dr. Mohanan says, somebody shouldn't make another legal issue about it. That in spite of the fact that there were existing in place, if someone did not allow a virtual meeting.
Yeah, if someone makes that thing, once we circulate that GBM will be held, we'll be able to know whether there will be any case or litigation or not. We have taken already the caveats. I am giving you the information. We have already taken the caveats against this.
Perfect.
So the legal peoples are in the loop.
Okay.
Regarding the AGM, we have taken the caveats in the High Court, in the local 5 courts. Okay.
Okay. Good. Good.
Yes.
And I'm a relieved man.
I will be at least.
I will be able to assume the position of the president.
Mundal. Annual report, sir. And other resolutions.
Annual report to be sent and presented in the GBM. Audited accounts and the budgets are to be passed there. Various resolutions taken at various executive committee meetings will have to be ratified at the AGM, and installation of the office bearers of CSI to be done there.
So these are the official requirements, and as you have already
guided us,
that annual report will be sent. Annual report will be sent both physically as well as in print, in electronic form. Actually, it is being done for last so many years. We'll be doing the same thing this year also. We'll be sending by mass mail as well as it will be sent by physical paper also.
And again, government has it is valid to send it by mail also. It is not necessarily possibly to send it by post. Possibly, that's what the legality says. You can take it.
Mohanan, could you repeat?
There may not be any necessity for sending the annual report physically. By even mail is accepted nowadays.
Yes, yes, okay. That is the rule. But we are sending it for everybody's convenience. We'll be sending both. Okay? Okay, so we have taken all the decisions, and you have been sent the paper for signing the attendance for the meeting. So you'll have to send it by putting your signature like the previous meeting done virtually. And we are incorporating all these 5 points, resolutions actually. These are all decisions, and we'll be giving some of the impression to our organizing secretary, Dr. Dani, after we finish the meeting. Yes, so we are taking all these decisions and resolutions, whatever we have taken in the form of resolutions. So I hope that we can write the word unanimous. Can I?
Yes.
Okay. Right. So unanimous decisions have been taken on all these 5 points, and the description will be written. Say, for example, why I'm putting it again, the description. If the hybrid meeting is held, and if it is a better condition at that point of time, then definitely the hours will be increased. Otherwise, everything will be put on virtually, even if the person gives the lecture from there itself.
Fine.
Okay.
Okay.
So thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Participation and detailed discussion.
Thank you.
And it was a really very nice meeting. It was very important indeed, because I wanted this to be hastened rather than putting it in the month of September, because even if it is a virtual sort, Dr. Mohanan will have to organize everything in that fashion, actually. That is the
Manal,
reason
thank you.
It has been
Manal?
Yes, yes, Dr. Goswami, please continue.
There is one query that when we call for emergency EC meeting, there is only one agenda, if I remember correctly. And yes, we discuss five. That is all right.
No, we have already discussed about this. Actually, constitutional obligation was the single agenda.
Mm-hmm.
And these are some of the agendas which are all parts of the same thing.
So don't make it five. You make it one and ABCD.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Ah, right.
That's
right.
Fine. That's fine suggestion. That's fine suggestion.
There is one point agenda. Whatever you make it, and
yeah,
these are the parts.
The ABCD five.
Not one. Not mention five agenda. Five.
No, no,
five.
Not
five.
It's not five agenda. It
will one agenda. One agenda.
Yeah. One agenda.
Only one agenda and one decision.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Thank you very much, Dr. Goswami. Yes, Dr. Singh. Dr. Singh.
Yeah.
You wanted to say something.
Nada, okay, it's fine on anyone's decision.
So you have to book on 2 days, on one on 31st of October and the other on 7th of November. So 2 days.
8th of November. No, let us keep it on the 8th of November.
Yes.
Keep it 8th. So that
he should come on 7th and work is on the 8th. He should come on 7th.
Surely. 8th of November.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
So
thank you, sir, on behalf of the headquarters. Thank you all.
Oh, Khan sir.
Thank you.
We are closing the session, okay?
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.